Hello, and welcome back to our channel. Today we're diving into a profoundly important topic, one that transcends the usual technical and lighthearted discussions we often have about the open source world. This is a serious subject, and I invite you to join me in a thoughtful and thorough reflection. Today, we will be talking about Slackware, the longest-standing Linux distribution in existence, and why everyone should try installing and using it at least once in their lifetime. We'll explore the challenges that technology imposes on us and how we relate to them. Slackware is not just a distribution, it's a way of seeing things and the world, a perspective that I personally share. I believe that the message its founder intended to convey by developing and maintaining this distribution, while always adhering to its core principles, is extremely relevant and crucial today. Let's take a brief look at the history of Slackware for those who might not be familiar with it. And to those of you who already know this story, I apologize for the repetition, but please don't leave the video. I believe the second part is worth watching, and your opinion is very important. Slackware was created by Patrick Volkerding in 1993. Yes, that's right. It's been around for almost as long as Linux itself. Patrick was a computer science student at Minnesota State University Moorhead when he started working on Slackware. His goal was to create a reliable and straightforward Linux distribution. At that time, there were very few Linux distributions available, and none of them were particularly user-friendly or stable. Patrick saw an opportunity to fill that gap. The first release of Slackware was in July 1993. It was based on the Soft Landing Linux System, SLS, which was the most popular Linux distribution at the time. However, SLS had a lot of bugs and inconsistencies, so Patrick took it upon himself to clean it up. He refined the package management system, improved stability, and added comprehensive documentation, making it much more accessible to users. What makes Slackware unique is its philosophy of simplicity and minimalism. It sticks closely to the original Unix design principles, which means it avoids unnecessary modifications and complexity. This makes Slackware incredibly stable and reliable, but it also means that it can be a bit intimidating for beginners. There's no fancy graphical installer here. Instead, users are greeted with a text-based installation process that requires some technical know-how. Over the years, Slackware has maintained its reputation for stability and simplicity. While many other distributions have adopted systemd as their init system, Slackware has stuck with the traditional sysvinit, preferring the tried-and-true methods over newer, more complex solutions. This commitment to simplicity is one of the reasons why Slackware has such a loyal following. Users know they can count on Slackware to be stable and dependable, even if it means sacrificing some of the more modern conveniences. Despite its old-school approach, Slackware isn't stuck in the past. It has continued to evolve and adapt to new technologies. For instance, Slackware includes support for modern file systems, advanced networking features, and a wide range of software packages. The package management system, while not as user-friendly as some of the graphical tools found in other distributions, is robust and powerful. Users can install, upgrade, and manage software with ease once they get the hang of it. One of the things that sets Slackware apart is its community. Slackware users are a passionate and knowledgeable bunch. Because the distribution doesn't hold your hand, it attracts users who are willing to dive in, learn, and solve problems. This has fostered a strong sense of community and a wealth of shared knowledge. There are countless forums, mailing lists, and IRC channels where users can get help, share tips, and discuss all things Slackware. Patrick Volkerding remains at the helm of Slackware, personally overseeing each release. This is quite rare in the world of Linux distributions, where most projects are managed by large teams or organizations. Patrick's hands-on approach ensures that Slackware remains true to its roots while still moving forward. His dedication and vision have kept Slackware relevant for nearly three decades, which is an impressive feat in the fast-paced world of technology. In conclusion, Slackware is more than just a Linux distribution. It's a piece of Linux history. Its commitment to simplicity, stability, and the Unix philosophy has earned it a dedicated following and a reputation for reliability. While it may not be the easiest distribution to use, those who take the time to learn it often find it to be a rewarding and enriching experience. If you're looking for a rock-solid Linux distribution that stays true to its roots, Slackware is definitely worth a try. Why should everyone install and use Slackware at least once in their lifetime? You have Ubuntu and Red Hat striving every day to create easy, intuitive tools that require minimal effort from the user. So why would you choose to use a system with such an old-fashioned concept that demands constant and significant user involvement? You might even be thinking that these videos are created using AI, and without these tools, I probably wouldn't be able to publish them myself. The reality is much deeper than it appears. While reality itself is simple, understanding its initial simplicity often becomes complex. Mastery and control are at the root of our success as a species. We are here, you and I, and everyone else, because we have explored and understood things over millennia. We are currently in the midst of the fourth industrial revolution, with the advent of artificial intelligence fundamentally challenging our approach to life. Our fast-paced society, with its demands for success, recognition, and appearance, takes up much of our time. On the other hand, widespread well-being and the availability of infinite resources leave us with free time that we often use to live superficially. We rely on simple, immediate, sophisticated, and gratifying tools that require little effort. I am a firm advocate of technology, provided we are its master and not its slave. Every day, I see many users desperately seeking solutions, while others frantically recommend the best distribution, the one that magically solves every problem with a click. I believe in graphical interfaces and think they are crucial for the success of GNU Linux systems among the masses. It is unrealistic nowadays to ask users to compile everything by hand, but it's fine as long as users are aware of what they are doing and how they are doing it. This is why everyone should use Slackware and learn how a Linux system works, how to manage a configuration file, and what it means to have total control over their system. Don't you think that beyond attracting new users, we should also focus on creating knowledgeable and capable users who can make independent choices without being influenced, because they possess a solid foundation of knowledge? All Linux distributions are wonderful, even the smaller and less significant ones, but there are some that are milestones, the Bibles of the Linux world, and Slackware is certainly one of these. For how it's built, for what it offers to the end user, and for the principles it stands for. It is simple and clear, providing you with the ability to understand and modify the system as you see fit. Therefore, for anyone using Linux and wanting to learn how a Linux system works, there is no primary option other than installing this distribution. It is stable, resilient, and reliable, on par with Debian. So, while for daily use I recommend Debian, Mint, or OpenSUSE, as an educational tool, I recommend Slackware. You can't be a Christian without having read the Bible, a Muslim without the Quran, or a communist without Marx. How can you claim to truly use Linux without knowing what it really is and what it does? Cars are on their way to driving themselves, technology will soon offer everything at our fingertips, and computers will create and think for us. But will we still exist? To exist doesn't imply being aware. To be aware doesn't imply knowing. We must use technology and artificial intelligence with awareness and power. They are useful and wonderful tools. It's a matter of mindset and perspective. So, what do you choose? Ubuntu, with its closed package system that delivers applications with a click? Or Slackware, where the command line package manager doesn't even recognize dependencies and you have to install everything manually? It depends on what you want, who you want to be, and what you want to do as a human being.